Hi Octoparse user, I'm François Dufaur. I'm a long-time user of Octoparse. In this series, I will share my experience and dive into multiple case tutorials with you, so you can use Octoparse to scrape data step by step. In this video, we are going to discover how to scrape a YouTube account. We have already done a previous video about the subject. The point is, many of you want to know how to scrape a YouTube account with the latest version of Octoparse, the version 8. You will see the process is the same, but things are slightly different. So, let's get started. Well, the first step is to enter the URL of the website you want to scrape in Octoparse. So, we go to youtube.com. And basically, we choose the account we want to scrape. So today, we're going to scrape the account of Ariana Grande. So we click on the account and we click on videos. Now, we copy the URL of her account and we paste it in Octoparse. In order to do so, we click on new and we're going to create a new task. So, advanced mode. And we paste the URL and we click on save. So in order to have an overview of the website we want to scrape, we switch on the browse mode and we click on continue. As you can see, the scraping process is divided into three parts. You've got the workflow box, you've got the overview of the website, and you've got the data extraction part. The second step is to create a scroll page item, because an important thing to know is that YouTube applies what we call the infinite scrolling. It means that to get new content, to have access to more videos, we need to scroll down the page each time. So in order to scrape all videos of Ariana Grande, we need to scroll down the page as many times as possible. And in order to create the scroll page list, we click on the plus icon below the go to web page and we click on loop. So we created the loop item, and in order to transform the loop item into a scroll page item, we click on the action settings and we click on here and scroll page. And as you can see, now you have access to a scroll page item. And here is the thing. In the previous version of Octoparse, when you scroll down the page, once it's over, you extract all the data at a time. So if the repeat times are set, let's say, to 20, Octoparse will not extract data until it's scrolled down the page 20 times. But with the new version of Octoparse, things are different because you can extract data while scrolling the page. So same thing, if the repeat times are set to 20, you will extract new data each time with each scrolling of the page. That's the first thing. The second thing is about this little checkbox, end loop when there is no more content to load. Well, what does that mean? Let's suppose in order to have access to all YouTube videos, we need to scroll down the page 100 times. If I input 50, well, it will scroll down the page 50 times as usual. But now let's suppose that you want to scrape another page and you only need to scroll down the page 3 times to have access to all the videos. As long as you check this little box here, even if you put 100, 1000, it will not scroll down the page more than 3 times. Because once you scroll down the page 3 times, well, there is no more content to load, so you can move on. So let's suppose that in this scenario, we set up a repeat times of, let's say, 100 and a waiting time of 4 seconds. You click on OK. The step 3 for us is to create a loop item. Basically, we need Octoparse to click to each video in order to get more information. So in order to select all the videos, we need to click on the first item. So we click on the title of the first item, and as you can see, the similar titles have been highlighted in red. So in order to select them all, we need to click on Select All, and now all the titles have been selected in green, which means that it has been successfully done. We click on Extract the URL of the selected element. Now we have some data in the data extraction field, as we have access to each URL of each videos. And once it is done, we do not forget to drag the loop item into the loop item we have just created previously. The step 4 now is to extract the data we need. And basically, we need Octoparse to click through each video for detailed information. And in order to do so, we are going to click on here and to select Click on Links to scrape the linked page. So we select the URL and we click on Confirm. And as you can see as a result, we have now access to each video and we can now select all the data we need. For instance, let's suppose that we want to get the title of each video. We simply click on the title and we click on extract the text of the selected element. And if you want to check the results, we simply click on the settings of extract data 1 and we can see that the text has been selected. Okay, so we can select the title. We can also select the number of views. So we click on the number of views and we click on extract the text of the selected element. We can also get the number of thumbs up. We click on extract the text. We can also get the number of thumbs down. We can also get the description of each video. So in order to do so, we need to switch on the browse mode to click on more. Then we switch off the browse mode in order to select the information we need. And now we can select the entire description. It's selected in green, so it's perfect. And we click on extract the text of the selected element. One more thing, if you want to select the publishing date, it is also possible. We simply need to auto-hide the workflow box, so we click on here, and then we have access to the publishing date. So we click on the 21st June 2021, and we click on extract the text of the selected element. And one last thing before we move on, if you want to double check the URL of each video, it is also possible. To do so, we need to click on Action Settings in Extract Data 1, and then we click on the plus icon, Page Level Data, and Page URL. And as you can see, it will simply select the URL of each video. If you are happy with the result, we can click on OK. Step 5. Running the task. Because now the process is over, we simply click on Save and then we click on Run. We choose Run on your device. And here is the result. To download the file, we click on Export Data and then we can export the data in an Excel spreadsheet, in a CSV format, or we can export it to a database. Actually, the choice is yours. In this video, I just described how to scrape data through a YouTube channel, but just be aware that the process is exactly the same if you want to scrape video information through a YouTube research. Hope my video got your confusion cleared away. Please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more videos regarding Octoparse and web scraping. We will always keep you updated.